With the African freelance workforce growing rapidly, driven by a young, dynamic population and increased access to digital platforms, there is a need to empower the youth. The Innovation Village, in partnership with MasterCard Foundation, Bakash Media and Craft Academy, recently organized the inaugural Freelancer Summit to unlock new freelancing opportunities, develop essential skill sets, and address the challenges within the gig economy. According to Japheth Kawanguzi, team leader at the Innovation Village, the success of freelancing in Uganda will require more than just skill set. It will demand a holistic approach and adaptability to new work trends.
In looking at the future of work, we built a community of young people who we call freelancers. Other people call them gigsters. And the importance is the knowledge that these skills that they have are needed everywhere across the world. They are needed, whether it's content creation, graphic designers, website builders, people doing marketing, and so many different skills, especially in a world where technology is ruling. So the skills are needed, and it doesn't necessarily need to be in a formal job that we're all used to, that I'm going to become a doctor, a lawyer, an engineer, an accountant. No, it is that these digital jobs or gig jobs are available and are demanded anywhere across the world just based off the talent.
Experts note that whereas opportunities may not always be nearby, but with the right skills and mindset, they can be found anywhere in the world. Kawanguzi encouraged the youth to focus on becoming exceptional in their craft so as to tap into opportunities across the globe.
Many people think we only have two options. Either you get a job or you start your own business. But there's a sweet space in between, which is what freelancing is. You might not have money to go to URSB and register, pay all these taxes and hire people. Or you might not get a job, so there's that in-between middle space. When we say freelancing, if you see Safe Border, Faras, all the border people who are speaking English and using Google Maps, that is freelancing one-on-one. It's a business, but it's also a job. I have no shop, but also I have no boss. So it's a beautiful kind of work. You have your freedom.
Freelancing is not a given. It's not easy for those that have tried it. So ours was to discover how best we can business model every individual freelancer to operate as if they're a business. Because when a client comes in, they are not dealing with you. They want the same experience they would get with an agency. They want the same experience they would get with a corporation, you know, from the beginning to end. So ours is to really empower and share this knowledge, open up our spaces across the country, provide micro insurance, provide access to financing. We have already started unlocking that. But basically to together unlock the mindset.
A report by the African Development Bank shows that the gig economy is expected to contribute over $300 billion to Africa's economy, with countries like Nigeria, Kenya and South Africa experiencing a surge in freelance activities in sectors such as software development, content creation, data analytics and graphic design. In Nigeria alone, the freelance workforce grew by 24% between 2021 and 2023, driven largely by young people, with 60% of Africa's 1.3 billion population under the age of 25.